Oh, sweet, seductive, sexy Satan, look at that body. Mmm, delicioso. I have come back to remind you once again of our previous arrangement. You have promised that if I can terrify you even once, you will release me back onto Earth. Well, I have a feeling that today's episode will indeed terrify you. Yes, yes. Today's episode concerns a mime, but not just any mime. What did you just say? Why would you say that to me? That's just horrifying. Oh, God.
Hell, the final frontier. Shut up, it is. He was executed over 200 years ago for his evil. Now Satan has made a bet with him. If he can scare the devil himself, he will be released from hell. Join Hieronymus Ominous and his two idiot assistants as they put on a show to horrify, to scarify perhaps even you, poor tormented souls of the underworld. Come, enter a little place in hell we like to call the cutting room. Just because.
Oh, minions of hell, it is time once again for the most terrifying part of your eternal damnation, for we have yet another episode of The Cutting Room. The second most popular show in all of hell, next to that stupid reality vampire show, Keeping Up with the Carpathians.
I don't know why that's so popular.
I don't get it.
I prefer Dancing with the Stars.
I like Sex in the City.
Sex in the City. Jordan, don't you mean in sex? You just mean Sex in the City.
Yeah, I'm like Samantha.
I knew you were slutty.
Oh, sweet, merciful, sexy Satan, in all of his wisdom, has given me two minions to help produce this show. The first is Eleni Riefenstuhl, a woman so evil that each of her nipples has their own nefarious purposes. I don't know what that means, actually.
Well, that means that the right side's going to take Manhattan, and the left one is going to take Berlin. And by Berlin, I mean Hamilton. That's the Berlin of Ontario.
Oh, Jesus. Ugh. I tell you. And my... I don't even want to keep going. Honestly, you just sucked the wind right out of this whole thing. And my second minion is Jordan. A man so incredibly gutless that, in fact, he defecates from the back of his own head. I mean, he's actually literally gutless. He's got nothing. It just comes right back out. It's disgusting.
You know, our medical records are supposed to be confidential.
Okay, you know what, Jordan? That confidentiality went out the window when I caught you masturbating in the nursery. Minions of Hell, today's episode is so completely terrifying, our most terrifying yet, that I must admit, I can hardly wait to see it. Lenny, can you hardly wait to see today's episode?
I can hardly wait to watch it.
Jordan, go fuck yourself. Yes, we can hardly wait to watch it. So, here we go. Because we can hardly wait to watch it. So now we're going to roll the show because we can hardly wait. I can hardly wait to watch this fucking show. Honestly, you're the worst fucking crew I have ever... Just cut!
I thought the show went really well today. Do you think the show went well today? I mean, my voice was really good, but I kept on worrying that I was gonna forget my lines because I've had Gaston on my lips ever since you gave me that ticket. Gaston on my lips, that would be a really good title for a book about him, don't you think? Man, the great Gaston, I'm going to see the greatest mime of all time live. Well, I guess it's better than seeing a dead mime. I mean, a dead mime wouldn't be much of a show now, would it? Really, Finnegan? This is the best gift that anyone's ever given me. I don't know what to say, I'm speechless. Like, you're so fucking amazing. How did you get that amazing? Ah, I bet every girl wanted you when you were younger.
I wish all guys were like you. I mean, you're so sharing and caring and loving, and I feel lucky that I found you because you're so special, and I gotta be your mother, I must be your mother.
You're so generous, I'm speechless.
Well, I'm just glad I could get the tickets. They were in demand.
You seem surprised.
It's a fucking clown.
It's not a clown, it's a mime. Gaston is a brilliant artist. He's a performer with almost otherworldly powers.
If you say so.
He's one of the greatest performers of our age. He's one of the few artists that's capable of conveying all of humanity and inhumanity without using words, with no voice at all.
Silence has its benefits.
Okay, well, whether you understand or not, it's still a wonderful gift. The plane ticket, too! First class, how did you afford that?
Well, I'll be coming in some money real soon.
Well, really, Finnegan, it's the most amazing gift I've ever gotten, and I don't know what to say. I'm speechless. It's a shame you can't come with me.
You know me. I've got some important business to take care of, babe. Headhunting.
You're not supposed to do that until everyone is gone.
Come in.
Hey, Veronica, everyone's gone. Do you want me to wait or?
No, don't worry about it. I have keys, I can lock up behind me.
All right, great. Have a safe flight, and can you get me a copy of Gaston's CD?
Ha ha, very funny.
That's great, thank you.
What was I saying again? Ah, how could I forget? Gaston the Great. I mean, you really have to go and see him sometime, Finnegan. He does this routine where he mimes digging a grave. I mean, it's hilarious and frightening all at once. Just wish I could make you appreciate how someone so silent can cut through to you so deeply. I mean, I think that under the right circumstances, if...
Shut the fuck up!
Well, Gaston, you saw the whole thing. What are you gonna do? Who are you gonna tell? Yeah, that's what I thought.
So here's my issue with the first part of this particular episode. I feel like it's a lot of talking heads. I think what it's really lacking here is atmosphere. Atmosphere is absolutely critical in horror. I believe it was Eisenstein who first said that atmosphere... Sorry, the digitized fluoro tube is broken?
Sounds like you made that up.
You totally just made that up. Why don't I just... bend over so you can blow the smoke directly up my ass.
Is it possible to get cancer again in hell?
Well, why is this stupid thing? It's fucking thing.
This is not a fucking joke.
I'm sorry. That was super uncalled for. That was really
your mother's actually quite a bit.
I've never meant to say those words.
I've never seen in my entire life.
Bam! This right in your fucking head.
We shouldn't have done
that. You get angry and you say things.
The first time it didn't seem right, and now we've done this. Okay, I won't do it anymore. No, I'm sorry. I'm very.
Pretend like you're stuck in a box. Hello? Hey. No, it's done. We're in the clear. No, I took it across town. You think I'm an idiot? It's in a bin marked medical waste. Go straight to the incinerator. I scoped it all out. Look, would you stop worrying, all right? How long does it take to empty out a savings account anyway? Relax, we're in the clear. Besides, everybody thinks she's gone. Look, just take the car, meet me in 30 minutes.
Would you shut the fuck up?
Fine, you wanna know? She died like a fucking mime. Didn't make a sound. Okay, I'll meet you in 30 minutes. Bye.
Thank you.
Red Mime would have been much of a show now, would it?
Look, I told you I'd be there in 30 minutes, okay? Hello? Hello, Sarah? Sarah?
Really, Finnegan? This is the best gift that anyone's ever given me.
You're dead! I fucking killed you!
It reminds me of the time I made a necklace of human toes.
That's really horrible.
You know, your hair, it makes me just wanna grab it and take your head and shove it between my boobies.
Yeah, when I wear my underwear too tight, all my fingertips tingle.